in search of truth. He undertook many arduous practices for many years and tortured his body, and yet he had not realized the truth. He understood that this path of extreme is not the way. He then took to the path of moderation. One day, sitting under the Bodhi tree in quiet meditation, the Buddha finally obtained enlightenment. His face glowed with inner wisdom. He had finally reached the truth. It was then that he gave the Four Noble Truths to the world. He said, "The world is full of suffering. There is so much unhappiness and pain around." Then he said that there is a cause for this suffering. Our endless desires and unlimited greed is responsible for all this suffering. Then he said that this suffering can be removed. One has to have an intense desire to end this suffering. And finally he said that the way to end this suffering is to follow the Eightfold Noble Paths. It is said that one day, when Buddha was sitting surrounded by his disciples, a great devotee of the Lord came to Buddha. He had been a devotee for his entire lifetime, and now he was nearing his end. He had a doubt in his mind whether God really existed. He came to Buddha and asked him, "Oh, respected one, is there a God?" The Buddha said, "There is no God." This news spread like wildfire. The wise one had finally spoken. He had declared that there is no God. In the evening, as the disciples were gathered around the Buddha, an atheist came to him. He too had spent his entire lifetime disclaiming God. But now, suddenly, he too had a doubt. What if God is? He humbly approached the Buddha and asked him, "Oh, Venerable One, is there a God?" The Buddha, understanding the nature of the atheist, said, "Yes, there is a God." This threw his disciples once again in great confusion. On deeper contemplation, they realized that each one has to realize the truth within oneself with diligent self-effort. Dear brothers and sisters, our beloved Swami too revealed the highest truth to each one of us according to our own spiritual capacity, gently guiding us on our spiritual journey forward. Bhagawan always encouraged each one of us to take the next step forward. Having been blessed to have been born at a time when Sai Buddha walked on earth, and having been doubly blessed to come in his physical presence, we have all experienced his immeasurable love and guidance. Let us not, dear brothers and sisters, fritter away this grand opportunity that destiny has bestowed on each one of us. Let us hasten our journey within, where Swami is waiting to embrace each one of us. My task here today is to introduce the speaker for the evening, Professor Lakshman Ravindra Vattavall from Sri Lanka. Professor Vattavall is a member of the Board of Trustees of the Sri Satya Sai Central Trust of Sri Lanka. An accountant by profession, Professor Vattavall is the president of the Institute of Certified Management Accountant in Sri Lanka. He has held numerous high positions in both state and private sector in the country. He was the chairman of one of the biggest banks in the country, director general of the Board of Investments, and an advisor to the Ministry of Finance, just to name a few. Professor Vattavall was also responsible for setting up two accounting bodies locally and has served as a board member of various institutes in Sri Lanka. He was inducted to the Hall of Fame of the Institute of Chartered Accountants within the country. It is my honor, dear brothers and sisters, to invite Professor Lakshman Ravindra Vattuval to share his thoughts with us on this auspicious occasion. Jai Sai Ram.
Om Sri Sai Ram. My humble pranams at the lotus feet of Bhagavan Sri Satya Sai Baba. Reverend Buddhist priests, chief coordinators of Zone 4 and 5, dear Sai brothers and sisters. Sri Lanka, as a foremost Buddhist country, are honored by the opportunity provided to give an address at the Buddha Purnima 2017 at Prasanthi Nilayam under the theme Ahimsa Paramo Dharma. Vesak is the most sacred holy day for Buddhists world over. Vesak is an observation of the birth, enlightenment, and parinirvana of the Lord Buddha. Lord Buddha has visited Sri Lanka on three occasions. The tooth relic of the Lord Buddha is placed in the temple of the tooth in the historic city of Kandy, known as the Sri Dalada Maligav. In the year 623 BC, during the rule of King Suddhodana, Queen Mahamaya, on her way from the capital Kapilavastu to Digdaha, her parents' home, gave birth along the way to a son under a large sal tree in the Lumbini Grove in Nepal on the full moon day of Vesak. The prince was named Siddhartha Gautama. Buddha Gaya in India is a place where Gautama Buddha attained unsurpassed supreme enlightenment. He eradicated all defilements, purified himself, and realizing things as they are truly are, attained enlightenment or Buddhahood at the age of 35 under a pipal tree referred to by Sri Lankans as the Bo tree on a Vesakti. After a very successful teachings for 45 long years, the Buddha, as every other human being, succumbed to the inexorable law of change, and finally, Lord Buddha's parinirvana, or the passing away, was in his 80th year, exhorting his disciples to regard his doctrine as their teacher. This too was on a Vesakti. I would briefly go through the Sigala Ovada Sutta, the discourse to Sigala, the layperson's code of discipline by Lord Buddha. The discourse to Sigala was translated from Pali by the Venerable Narada Thero and published by the Buddhist Cultural Center. Sigala Ovada Sutta, which belongs to the Digha Nikaya, in the Sutta Pitaka, is one of the most well-known discourses in the Buddhist world. This sutra is a record of the words of the Buddha to Sigala, a son of a multimillionaire in the ancient city of Rajagaha in northern India. Although the parents were strong followers of the Buddha, the son had no faith in the Buddha or his disciples. The father, in his deathbed, in his farewell address to Sigala, asks him to every day after his morning bath worship the six quarters as his final advice and passed away. Singhala carried out his father's advice, although he did not understand its hidden meaning. He thought that worshipping the six quarters meant paying homage to the six gods of six directions. The Blessed One, seeing Singhala with wet hair and wet clothes, salute with joined hands the six quarters, the east, west, north, south, zenith and nadir, decided to give him proper guidance to enlighten him. The Buddha, wishing this ritual to have more meaning for the young man, advised him in detail about how to live a good life as a layman. He phrased himself, as he apparently so often did, using lists, and begins by warning him against the many evils of the layman's life. And the Exalted One spoke as follows: Inasmuch, young householder, as the noble disciple, one, has eradicated the four vices in conduct, two, inasmuch as he commits no evil action in four ways, three, inasmuch as he pursues not the six channels for dissipating wealth, he thus avoiding these 14 evil things, covers the six quarters and enters the path leading to victory in both worlds. He is favored in this world and in the world beyond. Upon the dissolution of the body after death, he is born in a happy heavenly realm. The four vices are the destruction of life for killing, stealing, sexual misconduct or adultery, and lying. These are the four vices that he has eradicated. The four things which lead to evil are desire, meaning greed, lust or clinging, anger and hatred, ignorance, fear and anxiety. What are the six channels for dissipating or losing one's wealth? Indulgence in intoxicants, wandering in streets at unseemly hours, frequenting theatrical shows, indulgence in gambling, association with evil companions, the habit of idleness. These four young householders should be understood as enemies in the guise of friends. He who associates for gain, he who renders lip service, he who flatters, he who brings ruin. A good friend, on the other hand, is one who is always ready to help you, is steady and loyal, provides good advice and counsel, is sympathetic towards you. Finally, the Buddha discusses how one might best benefit from worshipping the six quarters. The east, a child should be good to his or her parents. A parent should be good to his or her children as well. The south, a student should be good to his or her teachers. A teacher should be good to his or her students. The west, a husband should be good to his wife. A wife should be good to her husband. The north, a friend should be good to his or her friends. Regarding the nadir or down, an employer should be good to his or her employees. Employees should be good to their employers. And finally, regarding the zenith or up, lay people should be good to people who have devoted themselves to the spiritual life, the monks, the ascetics, and the Brahmins. And people in the spiritual life, the monks, ascetics, and Brahmins should be good to lay people. Keep these relationships in mind, he tells Singhala, and the ritual your father asks you to keep will have greater benefits than he ever dreamt of. It can serve quite well as a guide to moral behavior for the common man or woman of today. When the Exalted One had spoken thus, Sigala, the young householder, said as follows, "Excellent, Lord, excellent." It is as if, Lord, a man were to set upright that which was overturned, or were to reveal that which was hidden, or were to point out the way to one who had gone astray, or were to hold a lamp amidst darkness, so that those who have eyes may see. Even so has the doctrine been explained in various ways by the Exalted One. I take refuge, Lord, in the Buddha, the Dhamma, and the Sangha. May the Exalted One receive me as a lay follower, as one who has taken refuge from this very day to life's end. With the blessings of the Triple Gem, Om Sri Sai Ram.
Swami, on this auspicious event of Buddha Purnima, we pray that you would bless us with your nectarine voice and grant us with the blessings of your divine discourse.
Prema Swarupulara,
embodiments of love.
Prachina Kalamunandu, Siddharthi, Gautama Buddhudu, ani peru ganchina vyakti, tana satya swarupanni gurtinche nimittamai, nirvana nimittamai, aneka sadhanalu santutu vachadu.
In ancient times, the one, the noble one, the Siddhartha, Gautama, the very personification of truth, to attain nirvana or liberation, did strenuous spiritual effort.
Aneka veda mantramalu kudanu patinchadu.
He repeated, recited the Vedic chanting.
Jagat nandukala peddalandarni kudanu darshinchadu.
He visited all the elders of those times.
Anni sadhanalu yendu kudanu taanu bhagamulu vahinchadu.
He participated in every spiritual endeavor.
Kattakalapatiki idi edi kudanu sariyaina sadhana kaadu ani satyanni gurtinchadu.
He realized the ultimate truth that none of them would give the liberation.
Bhagavantaru prasadinchinatuvanti pancha pranamalanu kudanu paramatmuniga viswasinchadu.
He had a strong faith that the five life breaths are divine.
Shabda, sparsha, rupa, rasa, gandhamu.
The five
indriyamulato kudinatuvantivi.
The five senses representing the sound, the sense of touch, and so on, they are divine.
ఈ పంచేంద్రియములను పవిత్రమైన మార్గములో ప్రవేశపెట్టి అనుభవించడమే నిర్వాణము అని గుర్తించాడు.
He realized the basic fact that nirvana or liberation is nothing but making use of the five senses in a sacred way.
జపము, ధ్యానము, యోగము, యజ్ఞము ఇవన్నీ కూడాను భౌతికమైనటువంటి యొక్క క్రియలే అని గుర్తించాడు.
He also has understood that the penance, meditation, all rituals are just the physical activities. If you have attachment to your body, such spiritual attempts are necessary. The one who is attached to the self need not do these activities.
Kanukane samyak drishti ani cheppadu.
So he prescribed samyak drishti, good
samyak
vision.
Vaku annadu.
Then he said good word.
Samyak shravanamu annadu.
Then he mentioned good
samyak
listening.
Samyak mananamu annaru.
Good recapitulation.
Samyak kriya annadu.
A good action.
Ee vidhamainatuvanti yokka aidu karmalu endukodunu doshamulu leka sakramaina margamulo sariyaina reetiga anubhavinchadame nijamainatuvanti nirvanamu annadu.
The true liberation comprises undertaking these five activities in a blemishless way.
Bhagavantudu ichinatuvanti ee netramulanu enduku pavitramaina margamlo pravesha pettakoddu.
The eyes gifted by God, why not they be used in a sacred way?
ఈ నేత్రములను దోషమైనటువంటి మార్గములో ప్రవేశపెట్టి
we make use of it in the mistaken direction.
అంటే దోషములంతా కూడాను పెంచుకుంటున్నాడు మానవుడు.
We go on increasing our mistakes.
మనసు యొక్క తత్వాన్ని మాలిన్యపరుచుకుంటున్నాడు.
We are polluting our mind.
మనసే మాలిన్యమైన ఇంకా మనిషి ఏ రీతిగా నిర్వాణం పొందగలడు?
When once the mind is polluted, how do you expect liberation, nirvana?
కనుక మొట్టమొదట సమ్యక్ దృష్టి.
To begin with, it is samyak drishti, good vision.
మంచి చూపును మనం అభివృద్ధి పరచుకోవాలి.
We should develop good looks.
ఈ దృష్టి యందు ఎట్టి దోషములు కూడాను ప్రవేశించకుండా చూసుకోవాలి.
We should see that our looks are pure, unpolluted.
See no evil, see what is good.
See no evil, see what is good.
ఈ దృష్టి వల్లనే సమస్త కర్మములు కూడాను పెరిగి సమస్త బాధలు కూడాను కలిగింపజేస్తున్నది.
It is the vision, the looks that are responsible for all the suffering.
మానవత్వమే మాలిన్యపరుస్తున్నది.
The very human life is contaminated.
ఈ దృష్టి చేసేటువంటిది చాలా గొప్ప పాపములుగా కూడా ఉంటున్నది.
The looks will certainly lead to sinful deeds.
దానిని సక్రమైన మార్గంలో ప్రవేశపెట్టి అనుభవించడమే సరైన నిర్వాణం అన్నాడు.
Nirvana is attained by making use of our sight in a proper way.
Buddha sadhanalu okkati kudanu ledu, sarva sadhanalu chesadu.
Buddha did all spiritual attempts.
Sarva sangha parityagam chesadu.
He renounced the whole lot.
సర్వలతోనూ సంబంధ బాంధవ్యములు కల్పించుకున్నాడు.
ఇన్ ఫ్యాక్ట్ హస్ గాట్ ఇంటిమేట్ అసోసియేషన్ విత్ కాస్మస్.
ఏకత్వాన్ని పొందే నిమిత్తమై అనేకత్వమైనటువంటి ఒక దివ్యాన్ని అనుభవించాడు.
He attained that state of oneness in this plurality or multiplicity.
కట్టకడపటికి సర్వసంగ పరిత్యాగం చేశాడు.
Finally he renounced everything around.
సమ్యక్ దృష్టి మొట్టమొదటి బుద్ధుడు బోధించినటువంటిది సమ్యక్ దృష్టి.
The first teaching of Buddha is samyak drishti, good vision.
తదుపరి samyak vak.
Thereafter samyak vak, good word.
Vak ఒకటిగానే ఉండాలి.
We should speak only one.
ఇది ఉద్వేగంగా ఉండకూడదు.
It should not be agitated.
అసత్యంగా ఉండకూడదు.
It should not be lying.
అన్యాయంగా ఉండకూడదు.
Or injustice.
అక్రమంగా ఉండకూడదు.
Or improper.
హింసగా ఉండకూడదు.
It should not be violent.
Anudvegakaram vakyam satyam priti hitam chettunnaru.
Whatever we speak should not be agitating, it should not be disturbing, it should be so pleasing, comforting and sweet.
Mana vakku hitanganu pritiganu udvegam lekundanu undali.
Whatever we say have got to be pleasing, so soft, delicate and sweet and acceptable and palatable.
You cannot always oblige, but you can speak always obligingly.
You cannot always oblige, but you can speak obligingly.
Kanukane samyak vakku annadu.
Good word is prescribed.
Pavitramaina vakku kante minchinatundi daivattvam vereokati ledu.
The sacred talk is the divinity.
Ee vakke shabda brahmamu.
This sound verily is divine.
Kanukane shabda brahmamayi చరాచరమయి జ్యోతిర్మయి వాంగ్మయి నిత్యానందమయి పరాత్పరమయి మాయామయి శ్రీమయి అష్టైశ్వర్య స్వరూపుడు భగవంతుడు.
Divinity is represented in eight forms, that which are mobile and immobile, in the form of light, in the form of sound, in the form of the entire creation.
ఎలాంటి పరిస్థితులు ఎందైనప్పుడు వాక్కుని ఏమాత్రము మార్చుకోకుండా చూడాలి.
Under any circumstances we should never go back.
ఉద్వేగము రాకుండా చూసుకోవాలి.
We should see that we are not agitated.
కఠినమైన పలుకులు రాకుండా చూసుకోవాలి.
We should never speak in a harsh way.
కనుకని ఇలాంటి మాటలను మనం నేర్చుకోవడానికి సరైన ప్రయత్నం చేయాలి. అది ఏ సాధన?
Spiritual practice wants us to speak in a way we are expected.
సర్వం ఏకంగా ఉన్నప్పుడు ఈ ఉద్వేగం రావడానికి అవకాశమే ఉండదు.
When we are all one, there is no chance to be agitated.
అన్ని అద్దములు యందు తన ప్రతిబింబాలే చూస్తున్నప్పుడు ఒక అద్దములో ఉండేటువంటి ప్రతిబింబం పైన తనకు ఎందుకు కోపం వస్తుంది?
In all the mirrors you find your own reflection, then you cannot be angry with another reflection.
అన్ని కూడాను మిర్రర్స్ వంటివి.
All bodies are like mirrors.
కాని ఈ మిర్రర్స్ లోపల నీ ప్రతిబింబాన్ని నీవు చూస్తున్నావు.
You see your own reflection in these mirrors.
కనుకని ఆ ప్రతిబింబంతో నీవు ప్రేమతో మాట్లాడాలి.
You talk in a pleasing way with the reflection.
ప్రేమకు మించినటువంటి యొక్క దైవం మరొకటి లేదు.
There is no other god beyond love.
హృదయంలో ప్రేమతో నింపుకున్నప్పుడు ఆ హృదయం నుంచి ప్రేమ పలుకులే వస్తుంటాయి.
When once we fill our heart with love, whatever we speak or have got to be loving.
Samyak vaku annadu dinni buddhudu.
This Buddha called it as good word, good speech.
Hrudayamulo enni marpulu kaligina kani prema marpulu matram ye matram praveshimpakoddu.
There will be many changes in our heart, but the love should not change. Ilanti prema
tattvanni matram marchakoddu.
We should never change our love.
Aa prema chetane neevu ee tyagam aneetundi danni andinchi bhagavantu yokka anugraham aneetundi danni pondachu.
With this love, following the path of sacrifice, you can earn God's grace.
Tarvata samyak shravanam,
then comes good audition. Samyak shravanam
ichadu bhagavantudu.
God has given us ears.
Endukosamu?
Why?
Aneka rakamaina matalu vinadanika.
Not to listen to gossip.
Kaadu kaadu.
No.
Idantha oka loud speaker vantidi.
They are like loud speakers.
Ee loud speaker lopala evaru maatladutunnaro aatma tattvani adi maatrame ee speaker lo raavali.
In fact, the ear, the speaker should permit the sound relating to the soul.
Aatma pratibimbame ee oka shabdamlo praveshinchali.
The sound should show the reflection of the spirit.
Aatma yokka vibration ee oka chevulu dwara manam vinali.
The vibrations of the soul should percolate through the ear, the speaker.
Andukosame ee loud speakers pettindedi.
So God has gifted these loud speakers.
కలగనే మనం శబ్దమును అపవిత్రం చేయకుండా చూసుకోవాలి.
We should never make this sound unsacred.
అన్నిటికీ అంతర్భూతమైనటువంటి లక్ష్యము లోపల ఉన్నటువంటి ఆత్మతత్వమే.
The principle of the spirit and the soul is the ultimate reality.
ఆత్మ అందరియందు ఒకటే.
The soul is one.
భిన్న భేదములు ఏమాత్రము లేవు.
There are no differences whatsoever.
నీయందున్న ఆత్మ కూడాను ఒకటే.
That soul is uniform in
all.
In fact, no different, no change.
ఆత్మ ఆత్మ స్వరూపమే.
ఆత్మ is ఆత్మ.
మానవుడు గుర్తించవలసింది మూడే మూడు.
Man has to realize only three.
ఒకటి వస్తుంది పోతుంది.
One comes and goes.
కానీ రెండవది వస్తుంది పోదు.
The second, it comes and it doesn't go.
ఈ మూడవది పోదు రాదు.
Third, neither it comes nor goes.
అజ్ఞానము.
Ignorance.
అజ్ఞానం వస్తుంది పోతుంది, వస్తుంది పోతుంది.
Ignorance comes and goes.
కానీ జ్ఞానము వస్తుంది నిలుస్తుంది.
Wisdom, when once it comes, it stays.
రాదు పోదు, అది ఆత్మ జ్ఞానము.
The knowledge of the self, it neither comes nor
goes.
It is permanent, eternal.
నిత్యంగానే ఉంటుంది.
It is eternal.
ఇది మార్పు చెందేటువంటిది కాదు.
It is changeless.
ఆత్మ జ్ఞానం అనేటువంటిది అమృతమయమైనటువంటిది.
The knowledge of the self is so sweet.
ఇలాంటి అమృతమైనటువంటి ఆత్మ జ్ఞానాన్ని నీవు పొందకుండా ఈ లోక జ్ఞానం నీవు ఎంత చదివి ప్రయోజనం ఏమిటి?
Without acquiring this nectarine knowledge of the self, what for this secular knowledge?
పుస్తకాలు చదివి 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 పారవేస్తున్నాం.
We read books so many and throw them out.
ఈ పుస్తకాలు ఉన్నటువంటిది ఎక్కడి నుంచి వచ్చింది?
Where from you got the matter in books?
మానవుని మస్తకం నుంచి వచ్చింది.
Matter of the book, పుస్తక, is out of మస్తకా the head.
దీనికి మస్తకానికే చేర్చుకుంటున్నావు.
So all the stuff in the book, pustaka, is taken into mastaka, the head.
Kani atma gnanamu pustakam kaadu mastakam kaadu.
The knowledge of the self is neither pustaka, the book, or mastaka, the head.
Tanamu,
it present in the heart.
కనుక మనస్తత్వాన్ని మొట్టమొదటగా కంట్రోల్ చేయడానికి ప్రయత్నం చేయండి.
ఫస్ట్ నో ది మైండ్ అండ్ ఇట్స్ నేచర్.
మనస్ అనేటువంటిది చాలా పిచ్చి పిచ్చిది.
మైండ్ ఇస్ ఎ మ్యాడ్ మంకీ.
ఇవన్నీ తలంపుల యొక్క చేరికని.
ఇట్ ఇస్ ఎ కాంబినేషన్ ఆఫ్ థాట్స్.
ఈ థాట్స్ వల్లనే మన మనసు యొక్క భావాన్ని మాలిన్యపరుస్తుండాలి.
ఇట్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ అవర్ థాట్స్ దట్ ఆర్ రెస్పాన్సిబుల్ ఫర్ సైకలాజికల్ పొల్యూషన్.
చేసుకో.
Understand clearly.
నీవు కోరవలసినటువంటి కోరు.
Have the correct desire.
నీకు ఆకలి అవుతుండాలి.
You are hungry.
నీవు కోరవలసింది అన్నమే.
You should desire for food.
దాన్ని భోంచేసి.
Eat well.
ఆకలి తీరుతుంది.
Appease your hunger.
అయితే మానవునికి ముక్తి కావాలి.
But man wants liberation.
ఈ ముక్తి ముక్తి అనేటువంటిది ఏమిటిది?
What is this mukti liberation?
ప్రత్యేకంగా కట్టి పెట్టినటువంటి ఒక ఎయిర్ కండిషన్ గ్రామం కాదు.
Mukti liberation is not air conditioning building.
కాదు కాదు.
No.
ముక్తి అంటే దానికి ముక్తాయం కావటమే ముక్తి.
ముక్తి means the fulfillment is mukti.
ఆకలి ఒక ముక్తి.
And this hunger is one kind of fulfillment.
భుజించితే ముక్తి వచ్చేసింది.
When once you have partaken your food.
అంత లౌకిక ముక్తులు.
These are all the worldly
fulfillment.
Suppose you suffer from a disease.
మందు తీసుకుంటే నివారణ అయిపోయింది.
Then once you take medicine, you are cured.
ఆరోగ్యానికి ముక్తి.
This is liberation from suffering.
కానీ మనసుకు ఒక ముక్తి కావాలి.
Mind needs liberation.
ఆ మనసుకి చంచలత్వంగా ఉండేటువంటి దాన్ని స్థిరం చేసుకోవటమే ముక్తి.
మైండ్ విచ్ ఇస్ వేవరింగ్ ఇన్ టు మేక్ ఇట్ స్టడీ is liberation. This is psychological liberation.
నీ ఇవన్నీ కుడును భౌతిక ముక్తులే.
All the rest are worldly.
నిజమైన ముక్తి ఏమిటి?
What is the true liberation?
రాదు పోదు ఆత్మ తత్వాన్ని గుర్తించడమే నిజమైన ముక్తి.
The true liberation is the recognition of the knowledge of the self which neither comes nor goes.
ఆత్మ ఒక్కటే.
The same spirit is present in all. ఏకాత్మ
సర్వభూతాంతరాత్మ.
The same soul is present in all beings.
ఇలాంటి భావాన్ని మనము తెలుసుకునే నిమిత్తమై బుద్ధుడు ఇన్ని రకమైన సాధనలు చేశాడు.
బుద్ధ డిడ్ సో మెనీ స్పిరిచువల్ టాస్క్స్.
దీనిని నిర్వాణము అన్నారు.
టు టీచ్ దిస్ విచ్ ఇస్ కాల్డ్ నిర్వాణ లిబరేషన్.
ఈ నిర్వాణము.
వాట్ ఇస్ దిస్ నిర్వాణ?
అనగా మానవుని యందు మూడు తత్వములు ఉంటున్నాయి.
మీనింగ్ మ్యాన్ హస్ గాట్ 3 ఆస్పెక్ట్స్.
అది ఏ నిజమైనటువంటి నిర్వాణము?
దేర్ లైస్ ద ట్రూ లిబరేషన్.
మొట్టమొదట
ద ఫస్ట్
సంఘ నీతి.
ద వన్ ఇస్ మొరాలిటీ ఇన్ సొసైటీ. ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్.
దైవ ప్రీతిని.
లవ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్.
ఈ మూడింటి యొక్క తత్వమే నిజమైన నిర్వాణము.
సో ద 3, ద లవ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్, ద ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్ అండ్ మొరాలిటీ ఇన్ సొసైటీ.
పాప భీతి ఉండాలి.
వన్ షుడ్ హావ్ ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్.
ప్రేమను చూస్తే ఆనందించాలి.
యు షుడ్ బి సో హ్యాపీ వెన్ యు ఆర్ లవింగ్. సంఘాన్ని
చూస్తే కలిసిమెలిసి ఉండాలి.
యు షుడ్ మింగిల్ ఇన్ సొసైటీ.
అది నిజమైన నిర్వాణము.
That is true liberation.
ప్రేమ స్వరూపులారా,
embodiments of love.
ఈ పవిత్రమైనటువంటి మనసును మాలిన్యం చేసుకోకండి.
Never pollute your mind with sin.
జన్మల యొక్క ఫలితం చేతను మానవత్వం మనకు ప్రాప్తించింది.
Because of all the merit of the past lives, you could be born a human being.
చాలా విలువైనటువంటిది.
Human life is highly valuable.
ఎప్పుడు విలువలు? ఈ గుణములు పెంచుకున్నప్పుడే విలువలు.
The value lies in these values, cultivation.
బుద్ధుడు చెప్పినటువంటి బోధ ఇదియే.
This is the teaching of Buddha.
కానీ నిజమైన బుద్ధుడు కూడాను ఈ రకమైనటువంటి దాన్ని అనుసరించి
In fact, even the teachings
nirvana, of God nirvana, nirvana ante moksham potame.
Nirvana means attainment.
Moksham kaadu ikkada.
Is not moksha liberation.
Neelo undinatundi paapa tattvanni pariharam cheskovali.
You just atone your sins, that is liberation.
Hrudayanni parishuddha parchukovali.
Purify your heart.
Sanghaneetini manam abhivruddhi parchukovali.
Follow the morality of the society.
Paapa bheetini nee పెంచుకోవాలి.
కీప్ అప్ దట్ ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్.
దైవ ప్రీతిని.
లవ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్.
లవ్ ఆఫ్ గాడ్.
లవ్ ఆఫ్
ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్స్.
ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్. మొరాలిటీ ఇన్ సొసైటీ.
ఈ మూడింటిని మనం పెంచుకుంటే ఇది ఏ నిర్వాణం?
వెన్ వన్స్ యు అబ్జర్వ్ ఫాలో దీస్ 3, దట్ ఇస్ నిర్వాణ లిబరేషన్.
కనుకనే దైవ ప్రీతిని మనం సంపాదించాలి.
హావ్ ద లవ్ ఫర్ గాడ్ మోర్ అండ్ మోర్.
పాప భీతి ఉండాలి మానవునికి.
మ్యాన్ షుడ్ హావ్ ఫియర్ ఆఫ్ సిన్.
పశువుకి ఎంత లేదు.
అనిమల్ హాస్ నో డిస్టింక్షన్.
కారణం ఏంటి?
వై?
పాపం అంటే ఏంటో దానికి తెలియదు.
బికాజ్ అనిమల్ does not know what
Baba
sin is. Baba,
this is what manavuniki papa bheeti ravali.
Man knows what sin is, so he should have fear of sin.
Fear of sin is
fear of sin.
Love of God.
Love of God.
Morality in society.
Morality in society.
Ee mundu yokka ekatvame nirvanam.
The one unit of these three is liberation.
Kanuka manamu sariyina margane anusarinchi mottamoti indriyalu arikattukovadanu chusukovali.
Let us follow proper path. First control our senses.
Kani appudu appudu deenni mannam chesukuntu
we have to memorize this thing.
Charge istu povali.
And we should charge our spirits.
Madhya madhya ee satsangam cherali.
We should join good company.
Satsangam cherthe ade charge ayipothundi.
In a good company we charge ourselves.
Kaga ee charge chesukuntu nu danni anusaristu pothe ivu ento abhivruddhi ayipoyi adarsha purushuluga meeru tayar avutaru.
By charging our spirits you will be certainly ideals in society.
Vahe guru vahe guru vahe guru ji bolo.
Vahe guru vahe guru vahe guru ji
bolo.
Vahe guru vahe vahe guru ji bolo. Vahe guru vahe guru vahe guru ji bolo. Satya naam satya naam satya naam ji satya naam satya naam satya naam ji bolo. Satya naam satya naam satya naam ji satya naam satya naam satya naam ji bolo.
Krishna 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 ji bolo.
Dearest Swami, the primary school students from the Sri Satya Sai School of Laos will present a dance consisting of two parts. In the first part, the children will lovingly invite you, Swami, to the celebration of Buddha Purnima. They will then move on to the second part of the dance, where they will portray the rich heritage of Laos.
Thank you.
The next presentation comes from the children of Nepal. The children of the Sri Satya Sai Center of Tahachal, Kathmandu would like to offer a musical skit entitled Krishna Sudama Milan. The skit represents the famous story of the divine friendship between Krishna and Sudama.
गरीबी से बुरा हाल धर्म पत्नी के बार बार कहने पर सुदामा ना चाहते हुए अपने बचपन के मित्र कृष्ण से मिलने चला। द्वारकाधीश के महलों के अंदर जाने का प्रयास किया तो द्वारपालों ने रोका, किधर जाता है? सुदामा ने प्रार्थना की, ए द्वारपालो,
देखो देखो ये गरीबी का हाल, कृष्ण के दर पे विश्वास लेके आया हूँ। मेरे बचपन का यार है मेरा श्याम, यही सोच कर मैं आस करके आया। से कह दो, अरे द्वारपालो उस कन्हैया से कह दो के दर पे सुदामा गरीब आ गया।
Yeah.
कह दो तुम एक बार मोहन से जा करके कह दो कि मिलने सखा बद नसीब आ गया है अचंभा हुआ रुक्मणी को बहुत ही अचंभा ये मेहमान कैसा अजीब आ गया है
ये मेहमान कैसा अजीब आ गया है
हाँ हुआ रुक्मणी को बहुत ही अचंभा ये मेहमान कैसा अजीब आ गया खुशी का समा तेरे करीब आ गया है
खुशी का समा तेरे करीब आ गया है
ना घबराओ प्यारे जरा तुम सुदामा ना घबराओ प्यारे जरा तुम सुदामा खुशी का समा तेरे करीब आ गया है
समा
presentation, lyrics of the song emphasizes on equity, equality, and unity in diversity.
Thank you. जय श्री गणेश विघ्न नाश गजानना गणेश विघ्न नाश गजानना विद्याबुद्धि सर्वसिद्धि सुनंदना विद्याबुद्धि सर्वसिद्धि सुनंदना जय श्री गणेश विघ्न नाश गजानना जय हे रम्भा श्री जगदम्बा नंदना मंगलदायक श्री विनादना मंगल जय श्री गणेश विघ्न नाश जय हे रम्भा श्री जगदम्बानन्दना दयाम्बानदायक श्री विनायक वन्दना जय श्री गणेश
सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु समस्तलोकाः सुखिनो भवन्तु ॐ
शान्ति शान्ति शांति।
जय बोलो भगवान श्री सत्य साई बाबा जी की जय।